Hello everyone, welcome back. The topic for today is we are going to see about the instrument in the conservative dentistry. So first we are going to see about the nomenclature, like how the instrument that you're using in the conservative dentistry, they are named. So in establishing a nomenclature for the hand instruments, Dr. G.V. Black, he prescribed four classes similar to the biological classification. So now we know we have that biological classification in which we have various like groups, that is the order, suborder, class, then subclass. Like similarly, G.V. Black, he also said that the instrument that we are using in the conservative dentistry, it is described in this four classes. So first one is the order. So order, it denotes the purpose of the instrument, like why exactly do you need that instrument. So example can be, it can be an excavator. So excavator, it is used to excavate the caries. Then it can be a scaler. Scaler is used for scaling. So that is the purpose of the instrument. Now what is suborder? So suborder, it denotes the position or the manner of use of the instrument, like how are you using that instrument, whether it is in pull or it is in push motion. So that is nothing but your suborder. The third thing in this nomenclature will be your class, that is the form of the blade, like how is the blade. So it can be a hatchet or it can be a chisel. And fourth is a subclass, so it denotes the number of angles. So there will be like one angle, or the instrument, it will be having like two angles. So that is nothing but the subclass. So now if you see that an instrument, it is named as, so for example, if you are naming an instrument called hatchet, so it is like we are going to name that instrument from four in the descending order. So that will be like bind angle. So that is the hatchet, is it is having two angles. So that is the subclass. Then hatchet is a class, then push is a suborder, and excavator is a order. So that is nothing but a hatchet that you use in your dentistry. The next very important thing that you see in an instrument will be the formula. Now this instrument formula, it is very commonly asked as a short answer question, and even many examiners, they ask you about this instrument formula even in your VIVAS. So you should know like what exactly the instrument formula is. So the cutting instrument, they have formula describing the dimensions and the angle of the working end. So that is nothing but the formula which is given to a particular instrument. Now we know we have that full set of instruments in our conservative dentistry. Now you'll see that if you see that instrument, so each instrument would be having some like numbers written on them. So this is the handle of instrument. So basically this is an enamel hatchet. So you'll see that on this handle, there will be some numbers which are written. So that will be nothing but your formula, that is your instrument formula. So this instrument formula, they are placed on the handle using the code of three or four numbers, and they are separated by dashes or spaces. So over here now you can see, so these are the numbers which are written on your handle of the instrument, and they are separated. So each number, it is like separated with the help of this dash, or it can be separated by the like help of spaces. So now what exactly these various numbers are, so that is nothing but your instrument formula. Now, which is the instrument formula which was given by G.V. Black? So in this instrument, now you'll see some instrument would be having three units and some instruments would be having four units number on this. So now over here, you can see there are three units. So this becomes a three unit instrument formula. So this three unit instrument formula, it was given by G.V. Black. And in this, the cutting edge of the instrument is at the right angle to the blade. Now over here, this is your instrument, that is the blade of your instrument, and this is your cutting edge. So in this three unit formula, you'll see that the cutting edge and the blade, they are at the right angle. So over here now you can see, so this forms the right angle. So that is a three unit instrument formula, and most of the instrument that you're using will lie in this three unit instrument formula, whereas the four unit instrument formula, so in four unit, basically instead of three numbers, you will have four numbers. And in your conservative dentistry, like around two to three instruments are only there which are having a four unit formula. So in this, now first number, now you can see over here, this is 10, 7 and 14. Now what do you mean by this 10? So that will be your first unit. So first unit is nothing but the width of the blade in tenths of millimeter. So now this is your blade. So the width of the blade is nothing but your first unit. And this width of the blade, it is in the tenths of millimeter. That means 10 is equal to 1 mm. So now you can see over here. So the width of the blade, it is 1 mm. And because of that, it is written as 10 on your handle. So that is your first unit. The second unit will be the length of the blade in millimeters. So now what is the length of your blade? So this is the length of the blade, that is 7 mm. So it is written over here, that is 7 mm. So that is your second unit in your 3-unit instrument formula. Now, what is the third unit? So, third unit is nothing but the angle the blade forms with the axis of the handle in the centigrades. So, now over here, this is the central axis of your instrument. Now, this line, this horizontal line you can see. So, this is nothing but the long axis of your instrument. That is the handle of the instrument. Now, this like third unit, it will be the angle which is formed by the blade. We are considering in this relation, that is the long axis of the handle. So, now you can see. So, this is your blade. Yes. So, this blade now over here, you can see. So, this line is your angulation for your blade. And this line is the angulation for your long axis. So, when the angle which is formed between these two is nothing but your third unit. So, it forms 14 centigrade. So, over here, it is written 14 centigrade. So, this like instrument formula is for your enamel hatchet. So, this is 10 is for the width of the blade, that is in tens of millimeters. So, 1 mm is nothing but 10. So, because of that, it is written 10. Then, the next is the second one, that will be your length of the blade. So, this is 7 mm. So, the enamel hatchet, it is having the length of 7 mm, that is the blade, that is the length of the blade. And the third will be the angle which is formed between the blade and the long axis of your handle. So, over here, the enamel hatchet is having this angulation of 14 centigrades. So, this is the third unit. So, that forms your third 3-unit instrument formula. Now, what is the 4-unit instrument formula? Now, we have seen the 3-unit instrument formula which was given by G.V. Black. So, 4-unit will be when the instrument, they have 4 numbers instead of 3 numbers. So, in this, the cutting edge of the instrument, it is at an angle other than the right angle to the blade. Now, in the 3-unit, we have seen that the angulation between your blade and the cutting edge, it was 90 degrees. But now, in this 4-unit, the angulation, it will be other than 90 degrees. So, over here, this is an example of a gingival marginal tremor. Now, you can see over here. So, the angulation, so this is your cutting edge and this is your blade. So, now, the angulation between this, it is not 90 degree, but it is other than 90 degree. So, that will be your 4-unit instrument formula. So, now in this, instead of 3 units, you have 4 units. So, in this, the first unit will be the width of the blade in the tenths of millimeter. So, it is same as we have seen for your 3 units. So, over here, the gingival marginal tremor, it is having the width of the blade as 1.3 mm. Now, we have seen that it is in the tenths of millimeter. So, because of that, it is written as 13. Now, the second unit will be the angle, the cutting edge, it forms with the axis of the handle in centigrades. Now, in this, like in this 4-unit instrument formula, this is the second unit which was like not present in your 3-unit. So, this is the difference between your 3-unit and 4-unit instrument formula. Now, in this, now we have said that the cutting edge and the blade, they are not at a right angle. So, because of that, there will be some angulation to your cutting edge. So, that is included in this 4-unit instrument formula. And that is nothing but your second unit. So, the angle, the cutting edge, it forms with the axis of the handle in centigrade is your second unit. Now, over here, this is the long axis of your handle. And now, you can see over here. So, this is your cutting edge. So, it is forming some angulation. So, the angulation between these two will be nothing but your second unit. And over here in this GMT, the angulation, it is 95 centigrades. Now, one point you need to remember in this is the second unit, it should be, so the value, it should be more than 50. So, the instrument, it is positioned so that the number, it always exceeds 50. So, this is an important point in your this second unit of the 4-unit instrument formula. Now, the third unit in this four unit instrument formula will be the length of the blade. So, it is same as of your 3-unit. So, in this, the GMT, it is having the length of 8 mm. So, over here, this is the third unit which is written, that is your 8. And the fourth unit, it will be the same, that is the angle between the blade and the long axis of your handle of the instrument. So, in this GMT, it is 14. And over here, you have to remember that the fourth unit, that is the angle between the blade and the long axis of your handle, it should be always less than 50. So, this is the main thing that you need to remember that the second unit, so in this like instrument formula, you'll see that the second unit will be always more than 50 and the fourth unit in this 4-unit, it will be always less than 50 and in the 3-unit, it will again, it will be always less than 50. So, this is an important point in this angulations. So, the example for your 4-unit instrument formula will be a gingival marginal tremor and an angle former. So, this is a distal gingival marginal tremor. So, this is the formula for your gingival marginal tremor. So this is nothing but the instrument formula, which is very commonly asked. So this is your instrument. So first unit will be the width of the blade. The second will be the angle between the cutting edge and the long axis of your handle. So this second unit, it is only present in your four unit instrument formula. The third unit will be the length of the blade. This will be the length of the blade, that is your third unit. Over here, this number will be the length of the blade. And the fourth unit, it will be the angle between the blade and the long axis of the handle of your instrument. So this is nothing but the instrument formula. So in the next part of your instrument in the conservative dentistry, we are going to see about the various classifications of the instruments that were given. Then we are going to see about the parts of the instrument, and we are going to see, or we are going to describe about each and every instrument in detail, because that question is very commonly asked in your vivas, that the examiner will give you an instrument and they will ask you to explain each and everything about it. So you should know like what the instruments are and why and where are you using them. So this was all about the main important question from your instrument. So that was your instrument formula. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, then please like, comment, share and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.